almost edible, doesn't it?
Almost.
Hi everyone. We're out in the Canadian bush today to practice some winter shelter craft. And what we're going to be building is a super shelter. If you're not familiar with the concept of the super shelter, it's an idea pioneered by Mors Kochanski, and it utilises a mixture of natural and synthetic materials to give you a very, very, very warm winter shelter. Now, I've never actually built one of these before, so luckily we have with us today Caleb Musgrave from Canadian Bushcraft, and he's built hundreds and hundreds of these things. So to help prevent things potentially going pear-shaped in sub-zero temperatures, he's going to lend us his expertise and show us exactly how it's done. The first thing we need to do is build a raised platform to get us up off the freezing cold snow. And for that, we use several large logs to build a square frame, and then we stretch thinner, more flexible boughs across the base of the bed, all the way across.
Push with that, come together.
Ah.
Again, cut off just a little bit. Now, the more it tightens, the more you struggle with it, the more it tightens. So, all together, I use very little cord, but I've got a solid frame.
Strong knot, yeah.
Next, we need to use some more flexible sapling type materials to build hoops over the top of the raised bed.
Also does is straightens out a whole lot of the hoops so they're all even eventually.
Now we need to use the true secret of the super shelter, which is mylar blankets. We stretch and tie down mylar blankets over the sapling hoops. And then we need to put tarps or plastic over the mylar blankets just to make everything waterproof. The final stage of the shelter build is to stretch a sheet of transparent plastic across the front of the shelter. And what that does is, if you build a long log fire in front of the shelter, then the shortwave radiation from the fire passes through the plastic and converts into longwave radiation, which is reflected from the mylar blankets down onto the sleeping bodies underneath and cannot escape back through the plastic. It works very, very well. And I think actually what we're going to have is we're going to have a couple of candles just hanging from the roof of the shelter, which will give us a little bit of extra heat. I'm not sure if we're going to have a fire tonight. With three people sleeping inside the shelter, there's going to be plenty of radiant body heat, which again will be reflected back down by the mylar. So I think we'll probably be okay without a fire, but we'll see. I think that's going to be up to Caleb, who's the expert on these things. We're in a rush now because the snow's starting to come down. As you can see, this morning we had a little bit of snow, a centimetre or so, maybe a couple. But that's good, just added to the insulating capabilities of the shelter. Well, we survived the night. It's quite possibly the warmest I've ever been in any improvised shelter, summer or winter. I'm very, very impressed with the performance. It worked brilliantly. We didn't have a fire in the end, but we had two candles hanging from the roof for a couple of hours before we went in, which heated up the shelter by a couple of degrees. And with the radiant body heat of three people in there was no problems at all. It was absolutely toasty warm. I could have done without Caleb snoring, but that's par for the course. But yeah, very, very impressed. Brilliant shelter design, and certainly one worth remembering if you're ever stuck outside in sub-zero temperatures. You should always carry mylar blanket and a tarp so you can improvise something like that. I had a little temperature sensor inside the shelter, and the external temperature got down to -8 degrees Celsius, and inside it was averaging around 1 degree Celsius. It did get down to about -2 towards 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, but there was a lot of condensation built up on the mylar and it never froze. So, and like I said, I was absolutely toasty warm, so yeah, very, very impressed. Big thanks to Caleb for lending his expertise. I believe he's going to have a video coming out on his Brothers of Bushcraft channel at some point, which will go into a lot more detail on how to build an effective super shelter, so you should definitely check that out when it's available. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful. As always, any questions, crews or problems, feel free to drop me a line. Cheers.